Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick coming to you from the wonderful, wild and wonderful Philippines. West Pacific, the wild and wonderful West Pacific here in the Philippines. Praise the living God, brothers and sisters. I hope you're doing all right today. I took off that microphone because I had remembered that I bought that little microphone for $2 or maybe $2 or $3. Here in the Philippines, because my old computer, something was wrong with the internal microphone. And so now, I think this one's going to be fine. So I'm going to try it. Let me know if you can hear me. If you can't hear me, then turn on the volume on your device and try it again. See if you can hear me. If you still can't hear me, if you can't hear me, then you won't know what I'm saying. So, but obviously, if you respond and say, Brother Patrick, I can hear you, then obviously you can hear me. Brothers and sisters, things are deep. Things are deep, brothers and sisters. That's what I want to talk to you about. I'm full of joy, unspeakable, brothers and sisters. Because the Bible says, you know, that the Lord is full of joy, unspeakable. Hallelujah. And full of glory. Hallelujah. Glory to his name. Hallelujah. Praise the name of Jesus Christ, the same yesterday, today, and forever. Hebrews 13:8. Hallelujah. Jesus Christ, the same yesterday, today, and forever. Hallelujah. Praise God. God is unmovable, unchanging. You know the big theological word, he's immutable. He's immutable. He never changes. God does not change. Hallelujah. Praise God. Praise God. He made different covenants with different people. Hallelujah. He made a covenant with Noah. He made a covenant with Abraham. He made a covenant with Adam. Hallelujah. You know, brothers and sisters, that's so simple thing. I want to talk about the vision that I had yesterday, but the Lord is leading me on this, so... You've got to roll with the flow of the Spirit of the living God. Roll with the flow of the river of God. Hallelujah. And the Lord was saying to me just now about Adam. The Lord made a covenant with Adam. Do not eat from the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. Now, brothers and sisters, that law does not apply to us because there is no tree of the knowledge of good and evil that we can go to and get fruit and eat from. Is that not true? Is it not true? My dear friends, Romans and countrymen, is it not true that there is no tree of the knowledge of good and evil we can go eat fruit from right today and eat, right, available near in a city near you? Is it not true there's not a tree of life that you can go to, a literal tree of life? Of course, the Lord Jesus Christ is the tree of life. But you can't go to a literal tree and eat from that fruit and live forever, like in the garden. Is that not true? Tell me, is that not true? Is it not true that that covenant, that command of God would not apply to us because the tree of knowledge of good and evil is not there anymore? Is that not true, brothers and sisters? Tell me that's not true. Isn't it not true? Hallelujah. Praise God. Hallelujah. For we do not live and die by the law, brothers and sisters. Hallelujah. For it's been replaced. You cannot go to Jerusalem today. Number one, you could not go into the temple area. Especially, it's so funny that lots of the Judaizers are women. You could not go in there. You'd have to go to the court of the women anyway. All the priests were men. And you would have to be a man, a Jewish or Israelite man, to go into where they were doing the sacrifices anyway. So you'd have to be an Israelite man to go there. And guess what? The temple is not there anymore. You cannot offer sacrifices anymore. After our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ was crucified, he gave his people Israel, after they rejected him and had him crucified, the Lord gave them one generation to repent. And they did not. And just as the Lord had prophesied in Matthew chapter 24, not one stone was left upon the top of another. Because when they went there, the Romans set the temple on fire in 68 A.D., and then the gold that was in the temple melted and ran down between those blocks. And just as the Lord had said, not one stone was left on top of another because the Roman soldiers broke apart every stone to get the gold that had melted down and ran in between, brothers and sisters. And the words of the Lord were fulfilled as they always are. Praise God Almighty. For God is truth. He is truth, he said. His word is truth. Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh to the Father except by him. Hallelujah. Praise God, and Jesus said in John chapter 17, thy word is truth, as he was praying to the Father. Hallelujah. If you ever want to know how Jesus prayed, the Lord's Prayer, people call the Lord's Prayer, That's what Jesus said when they said, how should we pray? And he gave them what people call, quote unquote, the Lord's Prayer. That's really the apostles' prayer, the disciples' prayer. The real Lord's Prayer is in John chapter 17 when the Lord prayed to the Father. It's recorded in the book of John. This is the words that Jesus spoke to his Father. Priceless words. I challenge you to go read it today. You want to know how Jesus and the Father talk and what they have to say? Go read it. Jesus said to the Father, let all of them be one, Lord, Father, as you and I are one. Hallelujah. That was the prayer of the Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. That we'd all be one. Hallelujah. That's the same book in John at the same time at the Last Supper when Jesus gave a command to his disciples. I give you a new command I give unto you, that you love one another as I have loved you, the Lord said. That was a command that the Lord gave his church. Love. To love and then love God with all your heart, all your mind, all your soul, and all your body, and all your being. And love your neighbor as yourself. Do unto others as you would have them do unto you. Love, love, love. The law of Christ is the law of love. Hallelujah. Agape love. And I love the King James word that it uses for love. It's charity. For agape. You know, they talk about it. Greek is much more complicated than English. You know, we have one word, love. In Greek, there's at least seven different words for love. One of them is agape, which is the love that the Lord is talking about. Sacrificial, God-like love. The love of God. The sacrificial, giving love. For God so agape the world that he gave his only begotten son. So God so sacrificially loved that he did what? He gave. He gave. That's why that King James word, without charity, I am nothing. It is charity. To give. To give. Not to do somebody a favor. Lots of times people confuse charity with doing somebody a favor. That's not, if you do somebody, you do something for someone expecting something in return from that person, that's not giving. That's not charity. That's doing someone a favor. They call it here pour favor, and that's what the people do. They do pour favor. I do something for you because I'm expecting you to do something for me. When the Lord said do something for people and expecting nothing in return from man. For God is the one who rewards us, not man. Praise God Almighty, brothers and sisters. Anyway, so we are not under that Old Testament covenant, brothers and sisters, as it tells us over and over and over again throughout the New Testament. Praise God! The Apostle Paul wrote in Galatians, he said that the law was a schoolmaster to bring us to the knowledge of sin and death. Hallelujah. In Hebrews, it says those things that are perishing, those things are passing away. Like an old garment. Hallelujah. That's why Jesus said you don't put new wine in an old garment because it will tear. When they ask him, why are your disciples not fasting like the disciples of the Pharisee and John's disciples? Why are your disciples not fasting? And Jesus said, nobody puts new wine in old wineskins because they'll tear. You put new wine in a new wineskin and both are preserved. Hallelujah. We're in the New Testament with the new wine of the grace and love of God. Praise God. Brothers and sisters, praise God. I'm going to come back with the message that the Lord gave me of the fulfillment of the more explanation and deeper levels of the vision that I have.